We have these intuitions for how things work in the real world. They're all based on the rules that science imposes on matter and materials, and so making the connections to the underlying science, I think, is very powerful. There isn't any magic, it turns out. It's all based on science.
So we have our coffee molecules. The coffee molecules are going faster than the air molecules. On average, they will be imparting, you know, positive energy to the air molecules. Okay, and that's going to happen over and over and over. And so then on average, you lose energy to the air and you cool down the coffee.
This seminar sort of struck me as a way of introducing science to non-scientists. And I don't mean subject matter exactly, oh, how do balls roll down hills or why do chemical reactions happen, but more how science actually works in the real world, who decides what science gets to be done, who funds science, and that for non-scientists, this was, you know, almost maybe more important than understanding a few nitty-gritty facts.
I feel like classes in high school are very focused and don't really teach you what science is in general. Like, you might have a chemistry class or a bio class, but you might not know what scientists nowadays are doing or what methods they use to, like, figure out those kind of things that you're learning.
And in this course, we have people from sciences, politics, I think almost every realm. We have a very, very diverse group. And then Professor Shaevitz brings it back to what we're talking about. I think that's a very important aspect to have in that course.
He sort of wants to include everybody, and I think it's very interesting how it bridges all those disciplines.
I think Professor Shaevitz does a good job facilitating, you know, conversation and debate and discourse, but we're also still learning and it's still a lesson, so I think it's a good kind of back and forth environment.
I wanted to have them sort of engage in kind of a hands-on way with various aspects of the way science is really done. One of the major projects that sort of has spanned the entire semester is a scientific proposal to bust a myth. They had to choose a common myth, motivate why it was an interesting question, and discuss the history of the myth, and to propose a scientific experiment that will bust the myth, as the Mythbusters would say. And as part of this semester-long process, we did a grant review panel, which is part of the way that we as a society decide what science sort of gets focused on or done. So I think that in many ways connects really to the way that we as scientists do things in the real world.
Oh, this is a good one.
That's revolutionary. Nice.
Thank you.
Anybody wants to come tie stuff too?
Oh, it looks cool from the bottom. So my proposal is on whether or not the house in the Disney Pixar movie Up could actually fly. I proposed building a scale model and then seeing if you could lift the house with a scale model with normal size party balloons. When I was doing research for my proposal, there's this whole new theory about these giant, giant balloons. The theory is that you could lift something like a plane that's fallen. You have real life applications for this idea of, like, lifting something heavy. And it sounds very simple, but it's applicable in the real world. And I think just by doing research, even though this one is a little bit whimsical, it just gives you more information on that subject.
My real hope is that we can, in some small way, just change the way the public thinks about science, scientists, and the scientific endeavor. The ability for the public to critically analyze some of this information on their own, where did it come from? Can they look in a little deeper? You know, how can they compare different types of information that are coming from opposite sides of the spectrum in the public sphere? That's something that I really think is important and doesn't happen much.
When I see something in the news that has to do with science, something like that, now I can sort of read it and be able to glean more out of what they're saying because I've been exposed to the scientific writing and the scientific methods that are often used.
There is a purpose behind science. You know, we'll never know when we need something. 20 years from now, that research could lead to some groundbreaking cure for a disease or some, you know, new innovation in science.
We're partly doing is we're trying to link, you know, sociology and the way governments and economics works with the way science is done, the way things have been discussed in history. We had some nice lectures on historical perspectives about evidence in science and mythological uses of myth. Bringing these connections together, I think, takes what could be a disparate set of broad topics as a liberal arts education and puts them together into, you know, a real synthesized view of human knowledge and human behavior and existence.